on Memphis Wrestling Primetime tonight. Thanks for joining us. As we said just a couple moments ago, there was some sad news to kind of start things off tonight. I'm joined by the King, Jerry Lawler, of course, joining me and Jimmy Hart.
Well, you know, it's nice to be out here. I want to say hi to everyone. But as you said, a little bit of sad news that we want to share. And I think we have a very special guest on the phone to kind of break the news to everyone. Lance Russell, are you there?
Yes, sir. Sitting right here ready to join in with it. And if I remember Sputnik pretty accurately, he wouldn't want any long faces or any of that kind of stuff going on.
Yeah, most definitely. Well, Lance, I know, Lance, sort of what you're referring to, some of the audience tonight may not know, is that on yesterday, the passing of the Diamond Ring and Cadillac Man, as we all affectionately knew, Sputnik Monroe, passed away on yesterday. And, Lance, thank you for taking time out tonight for joining us, Lance.
Well, I appreciate it, Corey, and given the opportunity to get in there. And I'll tell you, with the passing of Sputnik Monroe yesterday morning at about 8 o'clock in Alexandria, Louisiana, we had the passing of an era. I know in just about 50 years of wrestling that I've been around, I have never known anybody exactly like Sputnik, and I don't believe there was anybody like him. He had a mouth on him that was something else. He could tell stories like nobody. When you wanted to wrestle, he'd get in there and do it too. He's a plain out-and-out street fighter if he wanted to be. That was Sputnik Monroe, and he came to Memphis in about 1957. I remember that because that was the year that I came to Memphis, as a matter of fact. So I don't know whether that was too bad at peas in a pod or good happenings to Memphis at the time, Corey.
Well, it most definitely was certainly good to have yourself and Sputnik, both two legends that are famous with Memphis Wrestling, Lance. And we've got some other words. Lance, we'd like you to stay on with Jerry Lawler and Jimmy Hart. We're all out here tonight with all the fans here in the studio as we take a moment to remember Sputnik. Lance, please stay on. Jerry Lawler had, understand some words from Jerry Jarrett that Jerry sent in a statement.
Well, of course, Jerry Jarrett, longtime promoter of Memphis Wrestling here for years, and Sputnik Monroe, of course, worked for Jerry Jarrett many times. We talked with Jerry this morning. He just asked us to read this quick statement. Jerry said that Sputnik used the name Diamond Ring and Cadillac Man, and he was truly what his name implied. Not only a great talent in the ring, but he brought a smile to everyone's face in the dressing room. Jerry said he recalled one incident when he walked in discussing some other wrestlers, and Jerry made the remark. He said, "I don't know how stupid people think." He said Sputnik jumped up, opened his arms, and said, "Jerry, I can tell you how stupid people think." So Sputnik was just a great guy in the back as well as in the ring, and a lot of people got a lot of fond memories of the guy.
I'm telling you, a bunch of them. So many of them that I think we even got some pictures of Jared and also this next man that, Jimmy, you got a word from, talking about Hollywood, Hulk Hogan.
Right. I talked to the Hulkster yesterday and heard about the passing of Sputnik Monroe. And, of course, Hulk was back here during the 70s, and what a major star he's gone on to be. But he recalled one of the stories about meeting Sputnik when he was down here in the 70s and what a thrill it was to talk about his psychology in the ring on wrestling Sputniks, and that it was a big thrill for him. And he said he was the ultimate bad guy, and it's going to be a really horrible situation of him passing away like this.
Yeah, most definitely. That's words from Jimmy Hart, of course, of words that Hulk Hogan has said in the King. I think you had someone else.
Well, one more statement. Probably the most famous wrestler of that era, along with Sputnik Monroe, was Sputnik's longtime rival and nemesis, and that was none other than Billy Wicks. And, of course, we spoke with Billy Wicks this morning, and Billy had this to say. He said, "Let us honor Sputnik by remembering what a great life he lived. He was an innovator in a variety of fields, from the psychology of professional wrestling to equal rights for all races and creeds. His contributions to both these fields are still in use today, and most don't even know it. Sputnik managed to fit 120 years worth of living into only 78 years. And I know he had few regrets. He lived a hell of a life. May we all be so lucky." That's words from Billy Wicks.
One and only Billy Wicks. And also, Lance, while you're there, also, we had some words also. Dave sent an email. Dave Brown, your longtime partner, and Dave had these words to say. "We've lost a legend. Sputnik Monroe could be rough and gruff. He found fame as a bad guy, but he became a hero. Sputnik was instrumental in breaking down racial barriers in the late 50s and early 60s. He actively recruited African-American fans. He made sure they were able to attend the matches. If they were not treated right, he would refuse to wrestle. He was a fan of Memphis music and became lifelong friends with Sam Phillips and his family. Sputnik understood what the wrestling business is all about, and nobody has ever done it better. His Rushwood Park match against Billy Wicks is still talked about today, as one of the greatest sporting events ever held in Memphis. Sputnik Monroe, the diamond ring and Cadillac man, I'll miss him. Dave Brown. Lance? You there with us, Lancer?
Yeah, I'm right here, Corey. I'm listening to it, and I'm echoing, yes, sir, that's the absolute truth, everything that all the guys are saying about Sputnik. There was the one and only Sputnik Monroe, because this son of a gun, he was so different that he and Billy Wicks had that feud that went on in the early 60s, and it was like in 61 or something that they met in Russwood Park, the baseball diamond, which is no longer there now in Memphis, and had that huge crowd out there, and they were two entirely different kind of guys. Billy was a deputy with the sheriff's department, and he was a great amateur wrestler and all. Sputnik was a street fighter and a talker and everything else, and it was an amazing thing that this chemistry came together, and they had such a successful feud as Sputnik Monroe and Billy Wicks.
Well, thank you.
Sputnik for sure.
I'm telling you. Thank you so much, Lance. And as you're on the phone, and as of all our studios, fans are in the studio, rather, and all of our fans are home watching tonight, we're going to take one final look as the King and Jimmy Hart join me here at ringside. Take a look at the diamond ring and Cadillac man. Here is Sputnik Monroe.
Now the end is near, and so I face the final curtain. My friend, I'll say it clear, I'll state my case, of which I'm certain. I've lived a life that's full, I traveled each and every highway and more, much more than this. I did it my way. The record shows I took the blows and did it my way.
This is 235 pounds of twisted steel and sex appeal with the body women love and men fear. Thanks for coming out.
Yes, it was mine.